Thank you for joining us today for APL's Kitten Foster Training. We appreciate your willingness to open your heart and home to homeless mother cats and kittens. Your dedication allows our organization to rescue cats we would have otherwise have turned away due to limited space in our shelter. By fostering, you are making a huge difference as we take in over 1,200 kittens during kitten season. Who goes to foster care? Nursing moms with kittens. By taking them, you are providing a safe, healthy, nurturing environment for mother cats to raise their kittens. Bottle-fed kittens are kittens that have come into the shelter without a mom that need fed round the clock. Transitioning kittens are kittens that are off of milk and have started eating canned wet food or gruel, which is canned wet food mixed with warm water. Kittens that need socialized. These kittens need plenty of reassurance as well as love and attention. Medical kittens are kittens that have come in with an injury or an illness. Each foster parent will work closely with the foster care coordinator. This person is a staff member dedicated to you. They have a wealth of knowledge about fostering and about kittens. The foster care coordinator can answer questions for you regarding kitten-proofing your foster space, behavioral and dietary concerns, and basic health and medical questions. Your key responsibilities are that the kittens should be kept inside at all times, in a carrier when leaving the home, and in a room with doors and windows closed. If you have a screen that is securely in place, the window should only be open no more than 1.5 inches with a support in place so that the window cannot be opened any further. A frightened cat or kitten can escape through the tiniest holes. Kittens must be kept separate from your own pets. Kittens can come into the shelter and show no signs of illness for up to 10 days. Provide food, water, and lots of love. Expenses and donations. APL covers all medical care expenses for foster cats if permitted or performed at APL's on-site shelter. APL will not reimburse any personal expenses incurred by foster parents for unauthorized veterinary care. Seeking veterinary care for your foster cat or kittens at a clinic other than APL shelter is not permitted without explicit APL veterinary staff approval. APL will provide you with all needed supplies for your fosters, including a litter box, food bowls, litter, and food. If you would like to purchase your own supplies, it would be greatly appreciated. You can consult a tax professional to find out if your foster-related expenses can be used as a tax deduction. APL Foster Families Facebook page. This is a closed group. Foster Facebook group specifically for foster parents, and all foster families are invited. You can join by visiting www.facebook.com/groups/APL Foster and clicking the join button. The Foster Families Facebook page is a vital way to communicate with other foster families and the foster coordinator. You can use it as a support system or to post cute pictures and bios to help your fosters get adopted. Kitty proofing your home. Cat proofing and especially kitten proofing your home is much the same as child proofing it. That means hiding and removing cords, removing small items like rubber bands, paper clips, needles, and fish hooks. Anything that a kitty can swallow, you'll want to keep out of reach. Keep plastic bags, which can cause suffocation, as also out of reach. Don't use your good linens. We have plenty of towels and blankets here at the shelter that you can have. Housing. You must provide a clean, safe environment for your foster cats or kittens. APL recommends that you use a spare bedroom or a large bathroom as your foster room. Don't use the garage, as kittens can escape easily. An office that may have lots of cords, or a laundry room, as they tend to be too noisy. Bringing them home. The foster care coordinator will contact you to see if you are willing and able to foster. Once you agree to take a litter, you and the foster care coordinator will schedule a time to pick them up. You will be sent with a bag full of supplies, food, litter, and litter boxes, the carrier with your kittens, medical records and medications if needed. Naming the kittens. If you are taking home kittens that don't already have names, please name your kittens within 7 days and email or text the foster care coordinator with your kittens' names. Please use names that are friendly, non-offensive, and not too difficult to pronounce or spell. You can have fun and try to make them unique. You can use cute themes from your favorite movies, TV shows, or books. Moms will always have a name. Please don't change it, since it is what we have in our system. Neonatal guidelines. Neonatals are kittens that have just been born. Moms and babies. Handle newborns gently, but make sure to check on them at least twice a day. Make sure they are nursing, hanging out with mom, and not crying a lot, as this could be an indication that they are cold or not getting enough milk. If all kittens and mom seem well, your only obligation to mom and the new kittens for the first week or so is watchful supervision. Mom will need dry kitten food and water at all times. Kittens should be nursing up to 3 times an hour. The mother cat should be grooming each kitten after feeding and licking their bottoms to stimulate elimination. Things to watch for. Contact the foster care coordinator immediately at 217-801-3298 if you observe any of the following in the mother cat. If she is acting lethargic or if she is in pain. Lethargic is not active or kind of sleeping more. If she is ignoring her kittens. If she is bleeding from her vulva for more than 2 days. Has painful, hard, or swollen mammary glands. Contact the foster care coordinator if you observe any of the following in the kittens. Constant crying and failure to stay on the nipple. Refusal to nurse. Feels cold to the touch. Withdrawing from other kittens or rejected or ignored by the mother. Socializing kittens. Semi-feral kittens need daily handling. Sometimes they will spit or hiss. You want to gently pick them up and hold them close. They need a lot of love, attention, and reassurance. Daily attention, at least 1 full hour a day from you or other family members or friends, makes them more people-oriented and more adaptable. By spending time with your foster cats on a regular basis, you will not only increase their chance of being adopted quickly, but you'll also be able to determine their likes and dislikes. Behavior. You should monitor your foster cats for behavior problems, such as inappropriate urination or scratching furniture. If problems arise, contact the foster care coordinator to discuss behavior modification strategies. APL is not responsible for damages that might occur to yourself, others in your household, or your personal property as a result of feline behavior problems while in foster care. If you have cat-friendly dogs in your house, please consult with the foster care coordinator about proper introductions with your foster cats or kittens. Felines who have been raised with dogs and adult cats who enjoy or at least tolerate the company of canines also have an advantage on adoption days. We will provide you with Purina One kitten food. It's important not to change this as it can upset the kitten's digestive tract. You'll also want to feed canned food and always provide lots of fresh water. Here is your baby bag full of supplies. Your baby bag holds all your supplies and is in a good place to keep your foster medical records so everything is together. A laminated card on the outside tells you what number baby bag you have, what should be in it, and it gives the foster care coordinator's phone number in case of emergencies. If she doesn't answer, please leave a message. Please return your baby bag after each litter so we can refill it for the next foster family. You should find the below supplies inside. Please do not administer medication without consent from the foster care coordinator. Vaccine development and vaccine schedule. The FVRCP vaccine is for the prevention of viruses and upper respiratory infections. They get this and dewormer every 2 to 4 weeks until they are 4 months old. Vaccine reactions. Vaccine reactions can include, but are not limited to, limping, not eating or drinking the normal amounts for 1 to 2 days, lethargy, not active or sleeping more, pain at the site of injection, unwillingness to play, or a low-grade fever. A normal temperature is between 100 and 102.6. If any of these symptoms do not improve by 48 hours after the injection, please contact the foster care coordinator. Health concerns. Below is a list of health concerns. Concerns that are considered urgent are vomiting, which could be the cause of something underlined that we don't know about, bleeding, any bleeding from anywhere, straining to urinate or defecate, paralysis, not eating or drinking, and temperature too low. If the temperature is 98 degrees or lower, that is too low. Common ailments. Expect to see at least one of these while fostering. If you don't, you are one of the lucky ones. Diarrhea, a little bit of red blood in poop is okay. So is a little bit of bright red blood on the kitten's bottom. It is usually a reaction to something that they ate, new food, stress, or new location. An upper respiratory infection consists of lots of sneezing, yellow or green nasal discharge, and congestion. Please contact the foster care coordinator if you suspect that your kitten has an upper respiratory infection. Conjunctivitis is characterized by swelling and or yellow or green discharge around the eyes. Dehydration. General and emergency care. APL will cover all medical expenses done at the shelter. APL must approve all outside expenses. Foster parents should not seek medical care on their own without consent of the foster care coordinator. The adoption process. This will include pre-adoption, adoption, and foster parents can adopt as well. Getting your kitten seen. To get your kitten seen, we may ask you to take them to our off-site adoption events. They cannot be on any medications, and the foster care coordinator will contact you to arrange for the kittens to go off to an off-site location by Thursday at noon before the off-site adoption. We go to places like PetSmart in Springfield, PetSmart in Forsyth, the Petco in Springfield, our kitten circus at the shelter, and if we have space at the shelter, we may ask you to bring the kittens in to stay. Kittens are available for pre-adoption after 6 weeks of age, as long as they weigh 1.6 pounds and are healthy. Pre-adoption means the kittens will go home with the adopter until the kitten is ready for spay or neuter. The adopter pays the fee at the time of the pre-adoption and signs the pre-adoption paperwork. When the adopter picks up the kitten after spay or neuter, the adoption will be finalized. Kittens are available for adoption after 8 weeks of age, as long as they are 2 pounds, healthy, and have been spayed or neutered. Fosters can adopt too. You must go through the same adoption process as everyone else, and you also get first pick. Surgery. Call, text, or email when the kittens are 2 pounds or close to that for an appointment. Drop off between 8 and 8:30 at the clinic on the day of your appointment. Paperwork will already have been filled out for you. Do not fill out any new paperwork. Pickup will be the following morning between 7:30 and 8:30 at the clinic if the surgery is done Monday through Thursday. If surgery is done Friday, then you will pick up between 4 and 4:30 at the clinic. Please note that if you are late for a Friday surgery, you may be asked to reschedule. Cleaning for your next group. Remove all bedding and wash it in hot water with bleach added. Clean the litter box by emptying all the contents and wash with hot soapy water. Rinse well and then fill with hot water, add 1 cup of bleach and let sit for 10 minutes. Rinse and dry well. For food and water dishes, you can run them through the dishwasher and they will be cleaned for your next group. If you have carpeted floors, vacuum well and spot clean any areas that need it. If you have non-carpeted floors, sweep and mop the floor. Once the floor is dry, mop again with a bleach water solution of 1.5 cups of bleach to 1 gallon of water. Let sit for 10 minutes. Rinse with clear water and then let dry. Wipe down all surfaces with a bleach and water solution or Clorox cleanup wipes. Wipe the walls down. You do not have to do all of the wall, but at least the bottom 3 feet. The foster agreement. You must sign this before you start fostering with us. It is your responsibility to know what is expected of you. Compliance is a must for the health and safety of you and our kittens. Please return your baby bag at the end of each litter so that we can refill it for the next litter. Thank you so much for taking your time to listen and for opening your heart and your home to the kittens and cats in need.